What's up, guys? So I'm back with another video. I'm here to explain a very simple topic and explain it in a very simple and scientific kind of way. The topic is how is, first of all, cable station better, a cable better than free weights when doing isolation movements, okay? And what is this term constant tension that is attached with cables? The example that we'll be taking for the demonstration is a bicep curl, okay? And let me first just revise some of the basics. Let's go back to class 11th, 12th, 10th, when we studied trigonometry, right? So there was this aspect which we learned as sine theta and cos theta, okay? So I'll just tell you a simple thing which everybody knows, or mere engineer bhai to immediately samajh jayenge. This shaker is the free body, right? That is hanging from my fingers or hands right now. This is the direction, the downward direction in which gravity will be acting on this free body. If this body will be traveling in an arc, at different points of the arc, different angles will be there in which gravity will be acting upon the body. That the total mass of the body is not effective. So there is an effective mass of the body that will be there. So let's just say if gravity is acting at an angle, so the entire mass of the body will not be multiplied by 9.8 to calculate the weight. Sometimes at the point of the arc, maybe only 2/3 of the mass is acting downwards. Only 2/3 of the mass will be contributing to the weight. Only 1/3 at point will be contributing to the weight. So when you are doing dumbbell curls, you need to understand that when your bicep is fully stretched and at rest, the dumbbell being pulled downward by gravity, that will be the point where full weight is acting upon the dumbbell. When we actually get that dumbbell in that arc, you need to understand that the tension or the angle of the gravity acting downward upon that mass or that body is varying, reducing at times when we go and basically in that arc, it's going to vary. Sometimes maybe 2/3 acts, sometimes maybe 1/3 acts. So the effective weight that is pulling it down is varying. What is happening is that tension is varying. When you're doing a bicep curl with a dumbbell, the tension or the amount of tension acting on that dumbbell is varying throughout the arc. And there are points of time when the tension is completely off the bicep. Okay, that is why you're told to squeeze when you're doing your dumbbell curl, so that the tension remains there. Okay. So when you're doing cables, you need to understand that this is the cable weight stack, okay? And suppose you pin it at a particular point, okay? And when you're doing cables, then as you can see, the cable weight stack is what is moving. And it is moving in a linear direction, vertical, okay? So it's vertical and it's linear, right? So what is happening now, that the entire amount of weight that you have stacked on that cable is acting effectively downward. If there is no variance in tension, the entire effective mass of that stack is acting downwards. Hence, the term constant tension. Even in the arc motion, the weight stack is moving in a linear vertical line. That is why it is called as constant tension. The tension is not varying even if the arc is vertical. Even if there is an arc movement or a circular movement like a bicep curl. That is why you always will realize that you will not be able to cable curl the same amount of weight that you will be able to do on a barbell bicep curl. Hence the logic. That is the same logic we can follow for dumbbell flies versus cable flies. Okay. So if you're doing dumbbell flies, the arc will be there. So tension will vary throughout the arc of the movement, and there will be a certain time when you will be right at the top in a fly. You will see that the tension goes completely. That is why you're told to squeeze the muscle. You don't require that squeezing because there is constant tension in terms of cables. That is why when you're doing isolation movements and weight is not that important, constant tension, stretch, squeeze is important. That is why cables are the more potent when doing your isolation movements. You will always see you will have a greater pump and a tougher time doing cable curls than bicep curls, because you can't use that amount of weight and because the tension is constant. So it will help you better in terms of isolation. But why do I not recommend cables when you're doing mass building movements? Is because you, again, as I said, you can't use the same amount of weight. Okay, so when you can't use the same amount of weight, you won't be able to get that muscle overload. That is why I said cables is only better in terms of isolation exercises and not mass building exercises. Dumbbell curls and barbell curls are the best mass builders because you get that muscle overload, that strategic overload that you place on the muscle by using more weights. So the weight here is compensating to the varying tension that you will get with dumbbells. Okay, so you're strategically overloading the muscle because at points of time the muscle will be getting a full stretch and squeeze with the weight acting absolutely downward, and the weight will be so heavy that it will make up for that constant tension provided by the cables. This is one of the reasons you will actually see pros training on cable stations a lot more. Also, they're a lot easier on the elbow. The cable exercises are a lot easier on your joints than free weights. Okay, although that has a lot to do with the form that you do free weights as well, but generally the cables are a lot easier to do on, to move on your wrists. So yeah, that was the simplification scientifically, and I hope you understood, and yeah, I'll be seeing you. We'll be right back.